विश्वविद्यालय कुल गीत
पंजाब केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालय पंजाब केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालय संस्कृतियों का मिलन बिंदु विज्ञान दृष्टि धारण करके विद्या की इस फुलवारी से महके देश का प्रांगण सारा ज्ञान विज्ञान का मधुर संगम जीवन मूल्यों का सहारा ये नवाचार का पाठ पढ़ाता देश विदेश की समझ बढ़ाता भावी पीढ़ी का ये निर्माता विश्व बंधुत्व का भाव सिखाता तेरी शान रहे तेरा मान रहे पंजाब केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालय
पंजाब केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालय धन्यवाद जरूर कोई रखेगा चख लो
धन्यवाद। नमस्कार, पंजाब केंद्रीय विश्वविद्यालय बठिंडा के छठे दीक्षांत समारोह के इस पावन अवसर पर आभासी पटल के माध्यम से जुड़े हुए सभी महानुभावों, गणमान्य अतिथियों, शोधार्थियों, छात्रों एवं सभागार में उपस्थित विश्वविद्यालय परिवार के समूह सदस्यगण, आप सबका हार्दिक अभिनंदन। विश्वविद्यालय प्रथा के अनुसार कार्यक्रम का प्रारंभ पौधे को जल अर्पण कर किया जाएगा। इस अवसर पर मैं हमारे विश्वविद्यालय परिवार के मुखिया माननीय प्रोफेसर राघवेंद्र प्रसाद तिवारी जी कुलपति महोदय से विनम्रता पूर्वक आग्रह करता हूं कि आप परम श्रद्धेय कुलाधिपति पद्म भूषण प्रोफेसर सरदारा सिंह जी जोहल जी को साथ लेकर कार्यक्रम की औपचारिक शुरुआत की रस्म का निर्वाह करें। माननीय कुलपति महोदय, परम श्रद्धेय कुलाधिपति पद्म भूषण प्रोफेसर सरदारा सिंह जी जोहल, पंजाब के राज्य वृक्ष शीशम, जिसको पंजाबी में टाहली व अंग्रेजी में इंडियन रोजवुड के नाम से जाना जाता है, इस दीक्षांत समारोह के संपूर्ण होने के पश्चात विश्वविद्यालय प्रांगण में छठे दीक्षांत समारोह के स्मृति चिन्ह के रूप में यह टाहली का पौधा, शीशम का पौधा विश्वविद्यालय प्रांगण में रोपित किया जाएगा। धन्यवाद। धन्यवाद महोदय। अब मैं छठे दीक्षांत समारोह की कार्यवाही का आगे संचालन के लिए मंच पर आमंत्रित करता हूं हमारे विश्वविद्यालय के कुल सचिव श्रीमान कंवर पाल सिंह जी मुंद्रा जी को। श्रीमान
convocation of Central University of Punjab. Now I invite Honorable Vice Chancellor to request Worthy Chancellor to declare the convocation open. Welcome the dignitaries on the dais and present a brief report of the university. Scientist and also chairman of draft committee of special education. President of Sistan Location of University of Punjab and Honorable Chancellor, Professor Sadhana Singh Chaudhary, Professor Ram Krishna Sunika, Dean in charge academics, Professor V.K. Garg, Dean of Professor Anjana Munshi, Dean research, and Vice Star of University of Punjab. Members of the University Court, Executive Council, Academic Council, Finance Committee, Dean's Office, Subsidies, Head of the Departments, Learned Faculty Members, Officers and Employees of the University, and most importantly, my dear graduates, media persons, ladies and gentlemen. Namaskar and Sat Sri Akal to all of you. I, on behalf of the university and on my personal behalf, extend a very warm welcome to you all to the convocation ceremony of Punjab. It has compelled us to hold this most important academic activity of university in the virtual mode. It's a moment of pride for me to present a brief report on the progress made by this university. The vision and mission of our university is to uplift the quality of teaching learning and to make it current and relevant and of the world standard, to establish higher benchmarks in the research, to make it useful to the society, and to occupy a prominent place in the fields of knowledge creation, culturalization, skill development, entrepreneurship, and innovations. I am happy to share that within a decade time, Central University of Punjab has established new standards in the field of quality education and cutting-edge research. University started its journey in the year 2009 from a three-room camp office in D13 Civil Lines, India. In 2010, through great efforts of Professor Jairoop Singh, the first Vice Chancellor of this university, he moved to city campus spread over 37 acres. This campus catered the needs of the university for nearly a decade. Permanent campus of the university at village Bhutta was inaugurated by Sri Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank Ji, Honorable Minister of Education, Government of India, in virtual mode on 12th October 2020. In the gracious presence of Srimati Harsimrat Kaur Badal, Honorable Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha, Bathinda Constituency, Professor Jairoop Singh and Professor R.K. Kohli, former Vice Chancellor of the University, also witnessed the inaugural ceremony. My compliments to Professor R.K. Kohli for making untiring efforts in speedy execution of infrastructure development. We have started shifting from city campus to permanent campus at Gudda, and shifting is still in progress. However, all academic and administrative activities are performed from the new campus.
After a modest start with 10 students in 2009, currently university has around over 2,000 students in 31 departments spread over to 11 schools of studies ranging from science, technology, humanities, languages, law, social sciences and education. We have adopted choice-based study system, learning outcome-based curriculum framework, MOOCs and model curricula wherever available and supplemented them with local, national and global needs. In the academic front, currently we are offering 42 PG programs and 35 PhD programs. Many of these programs being interdisciplinary in nature make students of this university uniquely qualified. We admit only those students in PhD programs who have cleared UGC, CSIR, NET, GATE, GPAT exams and have fellowships. In the year 2018-19, a total of 44 students cleared such competitive examinations. However, in 2019-20, the figure rose to 174. This itself is testimony to the progress made by our students. Learning management system of the university that was customized by InfibNet was inaugurated by Dhirendra Pal Singh, Honorable Chairman of University Grants Commission on 23rd September 2020. Training of teachers on the use of LMS was also imparted by the InfibNet. Elucidating further, the online examinations of second and fourth semester students was conducted in July-August 2020 and the results were declared within 2 weeks' time. Online classes for third semester commenced in August 2020 and for newly admitted students of first semester on 2nd November 2020, third semester examinations are scheduled in the first fortnight of January 2021. University level orientation program for first semester students were organized on 2nd November 2020. Online student induction program on academic activities, library, computer science, student residences, and extracurricular activities was organized on December 17th and 18th, 2020. We have implemented the syllabus prescribed for UGC, CSIR.NET, but of course 20% customization according to local, regional, and national needs. Unwide Learn scheme is functional to make underprivileged students self-reliant on the one hand and inculcate skills in them on the other. 13 lectures were organized on NEP 2020, including 3 by the members of the draft committee of NEP. On the student strength side, university trains students for making them future ready for academics, industry, administration, and other walks of life. The focus of training is on personality enhancement, skill development, entrepreneurship, innovation through short-term value-added courses and field and laboratory-based projects. Sports and social connect is central to the train to make them excel in various aspects of life. The cultural diversity in the university is evident from the fact that out of 29 states, we have faculty from 28 states of India. Through Indian Council of Cultural Relations, Government of India, we admitted 10 students from foreign countries like Afghanistan, Swaziland, and Tanzania. There is no backlog of result declaration and convocation. Today, 535 PG and 20 PhD students will receive degrees in the gracious presence of renowned scientist Padma Vibhushan Dr. Kasturi Ranganji. 30 meritorious students who secured first position will be bestowed with the gold medals by our Honorable Chancellor Saab. 2 students will be bestowed with Sitaram Jindal Foundation gold medal. In the research side, 20 research projects worth 4.42 crores have been sanctioned by various funding agencies of Government of India. 5 departments, namely Environmental Science and Technology, Human Genetics and Molecular Medicine, Biochemistry, Pharmaceutical Sciences and Zoology, are DST FISH supported. 2 departments, namely Department of Botany and Chemistry, have already defended their proposal before the expert committee for DST FISH. Research papers published by the faculty till date are over 1,000 in Scopus platform, and the Scopus H index of the university is 45. The quality of the publications can be seen from the fact that these publications have citation over 10,000. Papers published after fifth convocation are 364 with cumulative impact factor of 1,210. Out of this, 41 are in the impact factor between 1 to 2, 184 in impact factor between 2 to 5, 30 in impact factor between 5 to 10, and 8 in impact factor more than 10. One paper is published in Nature, and 4 in Lancet. My compliments to teachers for such a robust publication profile and research grant. University has applied for DST Pulse grant, and it has also submitted proposal against a call for expression of interest to participate in pilot of gender advancement and for transforming institutions, that is GATI. And university has signed MOU with AIIMS Bhatinda to carry out collaborative projects and participate in joint academic activities. University is offering University signed MOU with for academic support with Trans Biomedicals Limited Mumbai and MOU with Sri Sri Deva Sattva Private Limited Bengaluru. University has also signed MOU with Department of Food and Public Distribution, Government of India, and Punjab Remote Sensing Center, Ludhiana, University of Lille, France, and University of Nevada, USA. The important achievements during the year are our ranking by NRF in 87th position, and we are proud to know that we are the only central university which was set up in 2009 to figure in top 100 by NIRF ranking. University is the nodal agency for 12 states for studies on invasive plants under National Mission on Himalayan Studies. University secured first position nationwide in the 15th National Youth Parliamentary Competition organized by Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs in 2019. Many alumni at the university are currently pursuing PDF or advanced studies in reputed universities abroad and has secured jobs in government sector. University has introduced exemplary and innovative reforms in the examination system. University has continuous surveillance system in the form of classroom quizzes, surprise tests, assignments, term papers, seminars, mid-semester and end-semester examinations. University has developed and uploaded 530 modules for EPG Pathshala, and university is also offering two MOOCs from same portal. University is offering two courses on solving the problem of fake news to non-journalism students. Our admission system is fully online since 2016. Students in the university are admitted through CUSET, and we are constantly improving our demand ratio. In the current academic session, for our PG program, the demand ratio was 1:22, and for our PhD program, it's 1:72. So in such a high demand ratio, the only merit, the only consideration that we have for admission of students in our various programs is the merit. Examination reforms have been successfully introduced. Continuous evaluation system through surprise test, midterm test, end semester test, and final examinations. All questions in the test papers are compulsory. This is unique feature of this university. And the end semester exam that's online starts with compulsory feedback from students about the content and teaching. Based on the feedback, remedial measures are taken wherever necessary. We have developed our own automated result processing and tabulation system that gives us error-free results and error-free degrees. Printing up individual DMCs and degrees with 13 advanced security features ensures 100% accuracy. The degrees that you will be receiving today are on the papers that are waterproof, fireproof, termite-proof, tear-proof. Moreover, no one can duplicate it. Through the web portal, the results are intimated to the students without any delay. Now we have incentives for best performance amongst the faculty members, amongst the staff, and also among the students. University gives Chancellor award of Rs. 5,000 for best student, Vice Chancellor's award of Rs. 5,000 each for best PG student and PG girls student. Selection of the students for these awards is based on comprehensive feedback from students, staff, and faculty through online mode on various predefined quantifiable parameters. For non-teaching staff, we have from 12 states of India, and here also, in order to encourage them, and also based on various predefined qualifiable parameters, we have introduced Best Employee Award in the from technical section, administration, and also from support services. And we give cash prize of rupees 2,000 each. Now we take pride in also saying that we have a meritorious, qualified, and committed faculty representing 19 states of India and trained at reputed national and international universities and laboratories. Majority of our faculty are trained in research abroad in good labs or taught there. All of our faculty are PhD and NET qualified. Faculty also includes DST Inspire, Ramalinga Swami Fellow, Ramanujam Fellow, PDFs, and UGC Faculty Recharge Program. In order to encourage the faculty, the university has introduced Best Teacher Award that is based on confidential feedback report from the students. Best Research Award, it carries rupees 20,000 for professional development. That includes attending conferences in India or abroad, research, membership fee of societies, or anything related to profession. It is given to those who secure research grant of rupees 1 crore or above, or who have published their papers in journals of impact factor more than 10, or have cumulative impact factor of their research papers 15 or more. Central University of Punjab Outstanding Research Award is based on well-defined scoring system. Teachers who get state, national, and international recognitions are given cash award of rupees 5,000, 10,000, and 20,000 respectively. Research seed money to faculty is provided to the tune of rupees 3 lakhs for science faculty teachers and 1.5 lakhs for teachers of humanities, social sciences, languages, and social sciences. This reduces their lag phase considerably for giving productive research. Teachers having research projects also have the option of utilizing up to 40% of overhead charges for their professional development. We have excellent facilities for research with high-end equipments, which are housed in central instrumentation facility. The campus is fully Wi-Fi enabled. University library is state-of-the-art, equipped with RFID, and is fully automated. Issue and return of library resources is also online. A braille system has been set up for visually impaired students. University has a proactive NSS cell, internal quality assurance cell of the university is proactive and collects and submits data on time to NAC and NIRF. It takes all possible measures for creating quality culture in all aspects of teaching, research, and administration. We have in place several committees like internal complaint committee, Students Counseling Cell, Equal Opportunity Cell, and SCST Cell. Engineering section of the university takes care of infrastructure development happening in the university campus. Finance section is ably managing the finances of the university as per Government of India norms. Examination section is ably discharging duties and ensuring timely declaration of results. We are fully conscious of our duty towards the society. University has adopted 5 villages to help and guide the residents on issues like sanitation, hygiene, and safe environment. Research team of the university is trying to screen the rural and urban population for early detection of colon cancer and other diseases. Additionally, 5 more villages have been adopted for extending education to the needy residents. To trace out the root cause of the issue of heavy metal contents in the subsurface water of Malwa region of Punjab and find measures to combat its adverse impact on the humanity, the university is in the process of making an integrated effort with multidisciplinary approach involving scientists from various organizations. This effort may yield concrete results in tracing the possible sources of these pollutants and remediation of surface water for making it potable. We wish to implement NEP 2020 on priority to ensure that the benefits that it offers in terms of learning opportunities, holistic and multidisciplinary learning, skill development, entrepreneurship, innovations coupled with moral and ethical advancement reaches the student community, and we are able to produce students with global competencies, ready to negotiate with the challenges of life and contribute for the socio-economic growth of the nation on the model of sustainability. We need to ensure that we provide transparent, responsive, accountable, participatory, proactive, student and teacher-centric and error-free administration that has absolute respect for the law of the land. On this occasion, we commit ourselves for taking this university to the greater heights through holistic development of youth. We believe in the paradigm that the purpose of education is to create a knowledge society which not only help improve the human development index, but also becomes champion of the idea of universal brotherhood, justice for all, and harmonious existence with the nature. My dear graduating students, this is not the end of learning for you, as the name Deekshant signifies. You have to engage yourself in lifelong learning and update your domain knowledge. In fact, through this ceremony, we are handing you over to the society and the nation. You are now needed to apply the knowledge and the wisdom that you have gained from your gurus in this Gurukul for the welfare of the nation and for taking forward our age-old tradition of living together with togetherness and for living in harmony with nature. Dear graduates, you are lucky to have received education in the sacred land which treasures the ocean of knowledge created by the 10 gurus for the welfare of the humanity. Bhatinda, where you are trained, is also called Guru Ki Kasi. Always remember the sacrifices made by the entire family of Guru Gobind Singh Ji for the unity and integrity of the nation, and Guru Nanak Ji's proclamation of those who cared for the lowest of the low, received the grace of the God, and derive inspirations for conducting yourself in life. I am confident that with the blessing of our Honorable Chancellor, Professor S.S. Joel, and selfless and unending support and cooperation from the faculty members, officers, staff, and students, we will succeed in creating a mark at the international level by becoming a well-known institution of higher learning. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Jai Central University of Punjab, Bhatinda.
I request all the degree recipients to please rise from their seats at the respective places and keep standing for exhaustion from the Honorable Vice Chancellor. Honorable Vice Chancellor, I request you to present exhortations to the degree recipients.
Dear graduates, I am privileged to present the following exhortation on this occasion and wish you good luck. Dear graduates, move into the future with eager and open hearts. Put the knowledge and intellectual enrichment gained here to use for the good of all humankind. Use knowledge to uphold the honor and dignity of your country and your alma mater. Believe in the goodness of life along with scientific temperament, humanism, spirit of inquiry and reform during challenges and difficulties. May you ever grow more humble and wise and strive for excellence in all spheres of individual and collective activity of life. Good luck.
The degree recipients, please rise from your seats at your respective places to take pledge with Dean in Charge Academics.
Candidate, please keep your left hand on the chest and right one stretched in front. Repeat after me. I shall make every effort in all circumstances to be honest and diligent in the discharge of my duties, to uphold the dignity of my profession and integrity of character. I shall use the knowledge gained here to uphold the dignity and honor of my country and alma mater.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, please initiate the proceedings of the convocation.
Let the candidates forward.
are deeply favored by teens of respective schools.
I request Professor Ramakrishna Vasruka, Dean in Charge of Academics, to present the candidates for the award of Doctor of Philosophy degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 20 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of PhD in various programs, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. PhD in Biochemistry and Microbial Sciences, Akanksha Khandelwal. Prem Prakash Kushwaha. PhD in Biosciences, Navratan Kaur. Shishir Upadhyay. Asim Majid. PhD in Comparative Literature, Priyanka Chandel. Jagdish Singh. Rajandeep Kaur. Sartaj Ahmed Lone. Vicky Kumar. Vishwajit Prakash. Naushad AP. Kiranjit Kaur. Ravi Shankar Kumar, PhD in Environmental Science and Technology. Leena. PhD in Molecular Medicine, Praveen Sharma. PhD in Law, Jitin Vijay. PhD in Mathematics, Kirandeep Kaur. PhD in South and Central Asian Studies, Shahbaz Hussain Shah. And Shiv Kumar.
May I request our Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the Doctor of Philosophy.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Biochemistry and Microbial Sciences, Biosciences, Comparative Literature, Computational Sciences, Economic Studies, Education, Environmental Technology, Human Genetics, and Molecular Medicine, Law, Mathematics, and Studies, South and Central Asian Studies, respectively, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove the worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor Ramakrishna Vasruka, Dean School of Basic Sciences, to present the candidates for the award of MSc degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 213 candidates who have successfully completed requirements for the degree of MSc in various programs of basic sciences, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. MSc Chemistry, Avinav Kundu, Jeevanjeet Patnaik, Rahul, Rohit, Jagpreet Singh, Shovik Mete, Kiranjot Kaur, Suraj Kumar Agrawala, Shamila Anjum, Soni Kumar, Avnish Kumar Singh, Archana, Sahil Jindal, Swati Gupta, Dibya Ranjan Boy, Tamal Kanti Bishwas, Jyoti Yadav, Meha Malik, Subhashish Achari, Sandi Kumar, Deepak Niyaz Ahmed, Shruti Swarup Patnaik, Kaushalya Rani, Parida, Neha Garg and Manisha. MSc in Chemistry, specialization in Computational Chemistry, Jyotirmayi Malik and Maria Francis, Akhil Shajan, Hariom Shukla, Ashish Navdeep Kaur, Mithun M, Harpreet Kaur, Rinto Thomas. MSc Chemistry with specialization in Applied Chemistry, Ayushi Gupta, Twinkle Jain, Priti Balav Patra, Deepti Mai Roth, Kapil, Vijay Saha, Subhashri Datta, Rajesh Khatwa, Ronit Nath, Bhagyashri, Farheen Sultana Ahmed, Tanya Subuddhi, Sanjay Kumar, Jagga Sabar, Santani Patra, Hitesh Malik, Shyam Dutt Sandwal, and Archo Masuma. MSc in Food Chemistry and Technology, Sri Lakshmi Priyapal, Sadhu Ashok, Shahrukh Khan, Vikrant Rana, Muneeb, Siyad PV, Chandra Inkti, Ankit Awasthi, Mrigya Bansal, Aishwarya Dhiman, Pirbi Rongpi, Satendra Pratap Singh, Garima Srivastav and Brahmeet Kaur. Now MSc in Life Sciences with specialization in bioinformatics, Devrat Pandey, Anong Longtang, Aditi Chaudhary, Payal Kumari, Ashish Kumar, Paulami Goswami, Vineet Kumar Mohanta, Duleshwar Singh, Mahima Bharadwaj, Anubhuti Chaube, Sneha Bhatt, and Jiro Carlo. MSc Life Sciences with specialization in animal sciences. So here Swati Ramachandran, Suryanshu, Damayanti De, Ajit Kumar, Jayashree Niharika, Shivani Agrawal, Dukhiram Kisko, Kanika, Vivek Anusha, Panwar, Paris Takyal, Biswani, Paricha, Rajiv Deka, Neha Pant, Liku Biswal, Gurmeet Singh, Debashish Roth, Jarana Sahu, Meghna Singh, Ashima Gautam, Pooja Kumari, Narinder Kumar, Chinmay Bhattacharya, and Akib Javed. MSc Life Sciences with specialization in biochemistry, Himanshu Raj, Piyush Kumar, Sarbani Bhattacharya, Sandeep Kumar, Saeed Mohammed Zaheer, Gulshan Maurya, Premkant Singh, Surbi Gaur, Sapna Thakur, Sharina Sara Joy, Pooja Nanda, Tarushi, Rahul Sharma, Manis Pratim Gogoi, Prem Mandal, Gudia Kumari, Manpreet Kaur, Piyusha Hazarika, Neha Nidhi, Ankur Singh, and Satish Kumar. Now MSc Life Sciences in Microbial Sciences, Shatakshi Kashyap, Ruchika Chaudhary, Paramita Pakira, Tushar Midha, Shweta Samant, Hilal Ahmed Ghani, Neha Gupta, Pragya Priyambada, Kajal Bankoti, Hemant Prakash Gupta, Richa Prakash, and Nafisha Packenstein. Now Life Sciences with specialization in Plant Sciences, Tanya Singh, Manisha, Mamata Mai, Sahu, Subrata Sarkar, Shweta Gupta, Venus Borgoi, Srimoyi Das, Buddhu Tejaswini, Josephina Joseph, Sonal Sangwan, Ravina, Somya Shri Bhoi, Amitos Deep Kaur, Ranjan Rashmi Parida, Shimran Yadav, Shilpi Tyagi, Sheetal Das, Swati, and Ish Palwal. The next one is MSc Mathematics, Mohammad Kizir, Mohammad Mukhtar, Ravish Anil Kumar Behra, Balkaran Singh, Sagar Vinayak, Mahesh Kumar Himanshi Chiteria, Vikas Smriti Singh Chauhan, after that Vitasta Singh, Mahendra Manda, Kapil Pushpendra Kumar, Surbhi Gandhi, Deepti Sebastian, Priya Bansal, Chaya Midda, Pooja Verma, Mohit Sharma, and Rakesh Kumar Sharma. Now MSc Physics, Kajal Garima Soni, M. Rudresh, Muzaffar Hussain, Rajat Kumar, Muhammad Khalid Ansari, Sheenam Bhatti, Himanshu Pant Rupali, Komal Poonam Kumari, Ajay Kumar Yadav, Kapil Nayak, Atikullah, who is an international student from Afghanistan, followed by Priyanka Rani, Rajashree Gautam, Tausif Ahmed, Garima Yadav, Rohit, Jayanta Kumar Mohanta, and Deepanshu Kharol. The next one is physics with specialization in computational sciences. Ayushi Agarwal, Rajesh Kishore Punya, Gaurav Kayal, and Dharna. And the next one is MSc in statistics, Lucky Kashyap, Sheetal Kumari, Mohit Garg, Kajal Chib, Anjana, Vinay, Shari Mangala, Doyal Ghosh, Aditya Das, Fasil Keti, and Veerpal Kaur.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MSc Chemistry, Chemistry Specialization Computational Chemistry, Chemistry Specialization Applied Chemistry, Food Science and Technology, Life Sciences Specialization Bioinformatics, Life Sciences Specialization in Animal Sciences, Life Sciences Specialization in Biochemistry, Life Sciences Specialization in Microbial Sciences, Life Sciences Specialization in Plant Sciences, Mathematics, Physics, Physics Specialization in Computational Physics, Stats, respectively, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove the worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor Raj Kumar, Dean, School of Health Sciences, to present the candidates for the award of MSc degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 41 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of MSc of various programs in School of Health Sciences, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. MSc Chemical Sciences, Specialization in Medicinal Chemistry, Sopanjin Sutar, Govind Kumar Dhakar, Rahul Kumar Chauhan, Ashurlochan Sahu, Rahul Verma, Priya. MSc Life Sciences with Specialization in Human Genetics, Amit, On Ali, Nisha Bilkiwal, Manisha Maji, Malvika Menon, Rahul Khan, Pragya Chaturvedi, Soparni Ghosh, Lakshmi Mishra, Anand Anunay, Kavita Kumari, Vidwan Sekhar Behera, Shambhunath Maji, Puneet Jain, Udit Chauhan, Muriki Ashwarya, Rashmi, Anesha Datta, Deepak Kumar Ratha, Sushrita Thakur, and Tanveer Ahmed Bhatt. MSc Life Sciences, Specialization in Molecular Medicine. Praneet Wahi, Ravi Kumar, Pooja Bharali, Sandra Babu, Gulam Mehdi Dar, Maharshi Ranjan Gautri, Saurav Banerjee, Amrita Arpita Paddy, Sadhan Kumar Bhardwaj, Aman Kumar Surya, Sonal Negi, Pooja Kumari, Subrata Banerjee, Kithuli Tho.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degree.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MSc Chemical Sciences, Specialization in Medicinal Chemistry, Life Sciences, Specialization in Human Genetics, Life Sciences Specialization in Molecular Medicine, respectively, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Dr. Sunil Mittal, Dean, School of Environment and Earth Sciences, to present the candidates for the award of MSc degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 38 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of MSc in various programs in School of Environment and Earth Sciences, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. MSc Environment Science and Technology, Aman Gangwar, Manraj Singh Dhillon, Pyasha Chatterjee, Aryan Kumar, Javli Chaudhary, Mamta Sharma, Saloni Sachdeva, Preeti Kataria, Kanwar Bhan Godra, Pintu Behra, Shabnam Sharma, Raved Ahmed, Akit Javed, Shabir Ahmed Dar, Pooja Sharma, Mahira Audicha, Aditya Krishnan, Anubhav Singh, Anjali, Trishna Barua, Manmeet Kaur. MSc Geography, Ritika Multonia and Tanmay Sarkar. MSc Geology, Ankita Divedi, Manjeet Rituraj Mohrana, Ayush Joshi, Dansrang Brahma, Salil Bala Sahu, Arjit Sahu, Devasis Prusti, Samad Ahmed, Salman Khan, Alka Kumari, Tushar Ranjan Mohanty, Priyadarshan Samal, Shishtha Islam, Anada Prashad, and Shilpi Kumari.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MSc in Environmental Science and Technology, Geography, Geology, respectively, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove the worthy of the same.
Now I invite Professor Raj Kumar, Dean of School of Health Sciences, to present the candidates for the award of M. Pharma degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 27 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of M.Pharm, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. M.Pharm in Pharmaceutical Sciences, Specialization in Medicinal Chemistry, Merugumala Kusuma, Kailash, Joydeep Chatterjee, Neha Devi, Nandini Thakur, Kaila Rushendra Kumar, Avad Bihari, Udita Malik, Shikha Thakur, Bharati Devi, Neha Dhiman, Agnidipt Das, Lavleen, Ankit Kumar Singh. M.Pharm in Pharmaceutical Sciences, Specialization in Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry. Abhishek Guchhet, Kumari Shivani, Priya Kondal, Tirumula Pediniti Srilasya, Ankur Kumar Tanwar, Anupam Rai, Taru Mishra, Kumar P, Rajat Sharma, Shobhana Thakur, Vibha Kumari, Tamanna Poswal, Aditi Sharma.
May I request our Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of M.Pharm, Pharmaceutical Sciences, Specialization in Medicinal Chemistry and Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor Amandeep Kaur, Dean, School of Engineering and Technology, to present the candidates for the award of M.Tech degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 34 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of M.Tech, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. M.Tech Computer Science and Technology, Suji Jain, Vibhuti Kumari, Supriya Kumari, Ritika Singh, Abdul Bahab Rehmani, he is the international student from Kabul, Afghanistan, Kumari Kajal, Shreya Suman, Vivek Kumar, Himani, Sayed Tufed Nabi, Avinash Trivedi, Ankur Prakash, Harpreet Kaur, Muzaffar Mehraj, Akib Iqbal, Gitanjali Pratap Verma, Shaima Mukhtiar, Faisal Mushtaq, Mehrajuddin Bhatt, M.Tech Computer Science and Technology, Cyber Security, Sagrika Paul, Ankriti Srivastav, Muhammad Vasim Bhatt, N. Srinivas Mudiraj, Muhammad Yasir Kote, Ishtiaq Manzoor Dhobi, Anupriya, Shubham Sharma, Vakil Ahmed Bhatt, P.P. Amli, Sabur Ahmed Kaul, Sarat Sasi, Yuvraj, Umar Farooq, Rupali.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of M.Tech in Computer Science and Technology and Computer Science and Technology Specialization in Cyber Security, respectively, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Dr. Shankar Lal Bika, Dean, School of Education, to present the candidates for the award of M.Ed degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 10 candidates who have successfully completed the requirement for the degree of M.Ed, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Ruchika Verma, Shajia Akhtar, Riya Gupta, Amit Ranjan, Surachi Gupta, Jamurad Ali, Aarti Rani, Shweta Rani, Nitin Kumar Manhans, and Manju Cheba.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of M.Ed and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Dr. Anand Thakur, Dean, School of Management, to present the candidates for the award of M.Com degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 22 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of M.Com, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Abin M. Jose, Rambhar Sahni, Shrijit M., Jasna Devasia, Muhammad Shaheen P.K., Uma Verma, Muhammad Hussain, Hari C.M., Vemula Louis Abhishek, Smile, Babita Devi, Kanu Charan Raut, Ajit A.C., D. Renuka, Shubham Sharma, Mirwas Bin Muhammad V.P., Gaju Sudhakar Yadav, Shriraj P.K., Muhammad Hussain, Mamta Devi, Ekta Sharma, and Juliet Jacob.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of M.Com and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor Tarun Arora, Dean, School of Legal Studies, to present the candidates for the award of LLM degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 16 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of LLM, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Minhaj ul Abidin Wani, Satya Mohan, Naved Ahmed Mir, Sajida Batul, Muazzim Sultan, Ruhi Ahad, Abil Hussein, Karuna Ramesh Patel, Basona Khatun, Prabhat Deep, Lokdeep More, Rahul SK, Muneeb Ahmed, Devanshi Garg, Ishrat Nazir, Shubli Ashraf Khan.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of LLM and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor Ramakrishna Vasruka, Dean, School of Basic Sciences, to present the candidate for award of MBA degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 13 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of MBA Agribusiness, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Dean Mohammed is an international student from Afghanistan. Arti Rishi, Siddhartha Shastri, Anubhav Shefali Sharma, Seema Rani, Dharavat Pul Singh, Samita Garg, Grima Rakesh Kumar Mato, Priya Upadhyay, Kavya V, and Sandeep Singh.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MBA Agribusiness and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor P.K. Mishra, Dean, School of Social Sciences, to present the candidates for the award of MA degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 33 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of MA in various programs of social sciences, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. MA Economics, Mohammad Arif, Ratika Grover, Akanksha, Anupam Sikha, Isabella Jose, Chidambarnath KB, Subhas KC, Sri Lakshmi K, Amrata P, Mohammad Basil P, SK Niyaz Mohammad, Jaswinder Kaur, Junis John, Disha Bajaj, Hemraj, Attaullah Nayaji, Samli Mohanan P, Manisha Datta, Kiranpreet Kaur, MA History, Sandeep Singh, Shupreet Kaur, Brighty M. Tom, Shima, Mohammad Iqbal, Apar Bandhu, Taslima CN, Chakraswar Dharavadhar, Mohammad Afzal, Salamunal Paris P, Umer Mukhtar KP, MA Sociology, Shubham Singh, Zulfikar Ahmed Khan, and Ramandeep Kaur. Thank you.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MA in Economics, History, Sociology, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor Zabir Pal Kaur, Dean, School of Languages, Literature and Culture, to present the candidates for the award of MA degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 39 candidates who have successfully completed the requirement for the degree of MA in various programs in languages, literature, and culture, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. MA English. Arolina Bhubaneswari. Yasir Ahmed. Rahul Soni S. Abhishek Panda. Don Joseph. Ronia Jose. Yogita Malhotra. Savan Kumar. Amal Roshan P. Lukesh Kalita. Moksha Sridhar. Mohammed Suhail P. Simranpreet Kaur. Ajaz Ahmed. Harish Thomas. Krishnendu S. Nair. Rahul Dole. Vanita R. M.A. Hindi. Ajay Kumar. Gagandeep Singh. Charanpreet Kaur. Monica Jindal. Lavdeep Kaur. Sukhdeep Kaur. Anshu Kumari. Sunita Rani. Gurmukh Singh. M.A. Punjabi. Harmanjot Kaur. Malkeet Singh. Karamjit Kaur. Sukhdeep Kaur. Navdeep Kaur. Gurmeet Singh. Manpreet Singh. Gobind Singh. Jagmohan Singh. Amandeep Kaur.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MA in English, Hindi, Punjabi, and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Professor Amandeep Kaur, Dean, School of Information and Communication Studies, to present the candidates for the award of MA degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 18 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of MA Journalism and Mass Communication, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Muhammad Sahil PM, Gitika Sanjeev, Suchibrat Arya, Sharon Matthew, S. Pushkar Patnaik, Sudhanshu Shekhar, Deep Shikha, Shobhan Kumar, Ravi Ranjan Kumar, Shafiq Ali T, Ritu Arya, Jaswinder Kaur, Shafiq Ali C, Arpana M V, Jishnu P P, Bahij B, Hasrat Gargi Chathanya.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MA in Journalism and Mass Communication and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Dr. Sunil Mittal, Dean, School of Environment and Earth Sciences, to present the candidates for the award of MA degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 13 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of MA Geography, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Parvinder Singh, Sunil Kumar, Manjeet Kumar, Bhumika, Rigjan Namgail, Pritisha Ghosh, Guljar Ahmed, Manteshwar Singh, Hani Kumar, Pooja Rani, Jyoti Chobe, Vakar Ahmed, and Uttam Kumar Parida.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MA in Geography and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
I request Dr. Baba Singh, Dean, School of International Studies, to present the candidates for the award of MA degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 10 candidates who have successfully completed the requirements for the degree of MA Political Science, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Mohammad Reza Farhang from Afghanistan, Donjon Vagis, Jadi Uday Kumar, Ajay Kumar, Gagandeep Singh, Ardra Rasmeen, Surya K, Rajni Mol, Uma Makhtar, Parampal Kaur.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MA in Political Science and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Now I request Dr. Shankar Lal Bika, Dean, School of Education, to present the candidates for the award of MA degrees.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present to you 8 candidates who have successfully completed the requirement for the degree of MA Education, to which degree I pray they may be admitted. Shaket Ali, Rashmi Ranjan Tripathi, Anjana Devi, Saddam Hussain, Robina Kosar, Deep Mala, Asad Shagir Malik, and Mohammed Javed.
May I request Honorable Vice Chancellor to admit the candidates to the degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of this university, I admit you to the degree of MA in Education and authorize you to wear the robes ordained as the insignia of this degree and charge you to prove worthy of the same.
Records of degrees conferred is submitted before the Honorable Vice Chancellor for signatures. Honorable Chancellor, I seek permission to present the medalist to receive the gold medal on being the topper of their respective academic programs. Sir, I request Professor Anjana Munshi, Dean Research, to present the gold medal recipient.
Honorable Chancellor, I present to you 31 candidates who have stood first in various subjects and they are being honored with the gold medal. Sahil Jindal, MSc Chemistry. Akhil Shahjan, MSc Chemistry with specialization Computational Chemistry. Shamdat Sanwal, MSc Chemistry, specialization in Applied Chemistry. Mamta Sharma, MSc Environmental Science and Technology. Mrigya Bansal, MSc Food Science and Technology. Ayush Joshi, MSc Geology. Sneha Bhatt, MSc Life Sciences, specialization Bioinformatics. Shivani Agarwal, MSc Life Sciences, specialization in Animal Sciences. Sharina Sara Joy, MSc Life Sciences, specialization in Biochemistry. Lakshmi Mishra, MSc Life Sciences, specialization Human Genetics. Shweta Samant, MSc Life Sciences, specialization in Microbial Sciences. Praneet Wahi, MSc Life Sciences, specialization in Molecular Medicine. Tanya Singh,
MSc Life Sciences, specialization in Plant Sciences, Himanshi Chitedia, MSc Mathematics, M. Rudresh, MSc Physics, Mohit Garg, MSc Statistics, Bharti Devi, M. Pharma, Pharmaceutical Sciences with specialization in Medicinal Chemistry, Anupam Rai, M. Pharm, Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry specialization, Faisal Mushtaq, M. Tech, Computer Science and Technology, Vakil Ahmed Bhatt, M. Tech, Computer Science and Technology with Cybersecurity as specialization, Shweta Rani, M.Ed. Education, Shubham Sharma, Commerce, Naveed Ahmed Mir, LLM, Samita Garg, MBA Agribusiness, Isabella Jose, MA Economics, Rashmi Ranjan Tripathi, MA Education, Gurjeet Singh, MA English, Bhumika, MA Geography, Ajay Kumar, MA Hindi, Ritu Arya, MA Journalism and Mass Communication, and Ajay Kumar, MA Political Science. Thank you.
Now I request Professor V.K. Garg, Dean Student Welfare, to present the Sitaram Jindal Foundation's sponsored gold medal recipient.
Honorable Chancellor, I present to you two recipients of Sitaram Jindal Foundation gold medal. This medal is awarded in the field of cybersecurity and medicinal chemistry. For this year, this medal is awarded to Vakil Ahmed Bhatt, M.Tech Cybersecurity, Bharti Devi, M.Pharm Medicinal Chemistry.
The records of gold medal may be submitted to the Honorable Chancellor for signatures. I request the Honorable Vice Chancellor to introduce the chief guest and request him to deliver the convocation address.
Good afternoon, sir. If you can hear me, please. Dr. K. Kasturi Rangaraju is currently Chancellor, Central University of Rajasthan, Chairman, Governing Board, Indian University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics, Chairperson, NIIT University, Neem Rana, Member, Atomic Energy Commission, Emeritus Professor at National Institute of Advanced Studies, Bengaluru, and Honorary Distinguished Advisor, Indian Space Research Organization. Earlier, sir has worked as Chairman of ISRO and oversaw the Space Program of India between the years 1994 and 2003. He was a member of the Upper House of the Indian Parliament between 2003 to 2009 and later the Earth Planning Commission 2009 to 2015. More recently, between July 2017 to December 2018, he was the chairman of committee that drafted National Education Policy. Mr. Kasturi Rangan is a member of all the four national academies and several international academies. He is a member of the International Astronomical Union and a fellow of World Academy of Sciences. He is the honorary member of the UK Academy of Sciences, Vatican City. Dr. Kasturi Rangan is the only Indian to be conferred the honorary membership of the International Academy of Astronautics, besides being its vice president between 2003 and 2005. He has won several awards, including Bloch Medal in 2004, Alan D. Emil Memorial Award in 2004, Q. Van Kadman Award in 2007, and the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award in 1983, among others. He has been conferred with the highest civilian honors, Padma Shri in 1982, Padma Bhushan in 1992, Padma Bhushan in 1992, and Padma Bhushan in 2000 by the President of India. The Rajya Sabha Prashasti Award of Government of Karnataka in 2014, and Award of Officer of the Legion, the Honor in 2002 by the President of the French Republic of France. We are thankful to you, sir, for inviting our most humble invitation to be the chief guest on the 6th convocation of Central University of Punjab and also to deliver convocation address. We are really fortunate indeed to have a scientist of international repute as the chief guest in the 6th convocation of Punjab and to also, it is prime privilege for graduating students who will derive immense pleasure and strength and morality and ethical values alongside the latest in the field of education from Dr. Kasturi Ranganji. So it's really a prime privilege for all of us to listen to Dr. Kasturi Ranganji, and I invite you, sir, to deliver convocation address as the chief guest.
Thank you. Professor Sadara Singh Jawal, the visionary chancellor of the Central University of Punjab, Bathinda. Professor Raghavendra P. Tiwari, Vice Chancellor, Sri Kanwal Pal Singh Mundra, Registrar, members of the Board of Management, members of the faculty and academic staff, graduating students, esteemed guests, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I would like to express my thanks to the Chancellor, Professor Jawal, Vice Chancellor Professor Tiwari, and other members of the management for inviting me to deliver the 6th convocation address of the Central University of Punjab. As an internationally acclaimed agricultural economist, Professor Jawal has guided and shaped the educational destiny of several institutions commendably and has been a key member of India's planning process in economics and also in agriculture. With this rich backdrop of academic and leadership experience, the honorary chancellor has led the growth and evolution of this university to commendable heights. Knowing the Vice Chancellor from the earlier years of his academic responsibilities, Professor Tiwari is a man of high erudition with deep commitment to excellence and quality in education. In his new role as Vice Chancellor of this university, he is certain to provide all-round guidance and leadership to take this university to even higher levels of achievement. On this August occasion, the first week of the new year and the new decade, I would like to greet each and every one of you, members of the faculty, students, and other support staff. I've seen that the university already imparts education in a large array of subjects, encompassing professional education in agriculture, law, and engineering, besides sciences and the social sciences and education. One can clearly see many ingredients that make a comprehensive education so what we characterize as a research cum teaching university as envisaged in our National Education Policy 2020. I may recall here in this context the policy related to the institutional restructuring and consolidation envisages a three-tier system of higher education consisting of research-intensive universities, teaching-intensive universities, and autonomous degree-granting colleges. I am delighted to know that the Central University of Punjab, Bathinda, is the youngest university among the top 100 institutions in the country, category in the NIRF rankings, a good example of an exceptionally fast ascent and consolidation. This university's excellence in performance owes much to the academic standing of its teaching professionals, who combine the best of the teaching methods with high quality research. It's also good to note that the university has both a national and international character in its academics and draws students and faculty from multiple states of India. I note with pride that Bathinda has been the home to forward-looking and enlightened citizens, staunch nationalists, and many of whom have given up their life as a sacrifice for the cause of this country. My dear young students, today marks an important day in your lives and a significant milestone in your life's journey. You have entered this institution facing intense competition. I have noted that only 1 in 50 students is accepted at the PG program and only 1 in 100 for the PhD program. Today's proud moment owes much to your hard work and dedication to maintain high standards. However, I would like to point out to you that the process will not end here, but will continue until you feel fully confident of meeting uncertainties and challenges of life and dealing with successes and failures with an equanimous attitude. I am sure that each one of you has different dreams. You should never give up your dreams and aspirations, for it is those aspirations that will drive you to higher levels of achievements and make your life purposeful. My dear friends, the path to great achievements and success will put enormous demands on you and call upon you to bring to bear the highest degree of professionalism, inspired by being a part of a path-changing knowledge ecosystem. This is, in turn, will imply continuous updating of your knowledge and thus making the process of learning a continuous one. The ancient Indian wisdom reflected in the following Subhashitam sloka is apt to the situation, and I quote, Acharya padamadatte pandam shishyasumedaya pandam sabrabhamacharibhyaha pandam kalakramena cha. In English it says, a student learns one quarter from his master, a second quarter accrues from one's own intelligence, the third from fellow students. Time and experience confer the last quarter. From the depth of my heart, I wish each one of you success in all your future endeavors. The vision of India's new educational system has been crafted to ensure that it touches the life of each and every citizen, consistent with their needs and necessities, besides creating a just and equitable society. The approach is to realize a new system aligned with the aspirational goals of the 21st century education, while remaining rooted to India's value systems and ethos. The policy provides an integrated yet flexible approach to education. Further, it has kept the interconnectedness of the various phases of education in mind and how the same will enable continuity, coherence, and processes to ultimately realize an end-to-end educational roadmap for the country. Major emphasis is given in the policy to the aspect of holistic, multidisciplinary education as a foundational component at the undergraduate level. Undergraduate degree will be either of 3 or 4 year duration with multiple exit options within this period with appropriate certifications. The 4-year multidisciplinary bachelor program provides opportunity to experience the full range of holistic and multidisciplinary education with focus on chosen major and minor as per the choice of the student. I am sure the vision of this university will expand further in the coming years to encompass undergraduate education, to derive the best of a continuous and holistic higher education system, including undergraduate research. At the postgraduate level, one of the key recommendations relates to the strengthening of research in the university system. The policy recommends the creation of a national research foundation for this purpose. The benefit of research funding will be available to both private and public funded institutions. A light but tight mechanism for regulation is envisaged under this policy, again applicable without distinction between private and public institutions, providing a more cohesive structure for higher educational institutions in the context of teaching and research, ensuring increased autonomy and empowered governance and effective leadership are the other features of the policy. On the whole, the policy aims at the development of all the requisite skills that are pertinent in the contemporary world of learners while giving enough flexibility in making choices consistent with the dynamics of a knowledge society. I may mention at this point that our Honorable Prime Minister had a number of sittings reviewing this policy before it was approved by the government, and he made some very thoughtful suggestions. Currently, the Honorable Minister of Education, Dr. Pokhriyal ji, has been carried forward the onerous task of implementation. It's a challenge which he is facing with all the resourcefulness and his extraordinary background in the field of education. I am sure India will see a new knowledge society in the coming years with this particular policy, which, as the Prime Minister rightly said, will be honored in letter and spirit as it goes into the implementation. Moving on to the discussions on aspects of educational policy, I'd like to share my own experiences in the context of the challenges that the professional world can pose to you youngsters in future. I'm saying this to the students. I use my own association with ISRO and some of the lessons which I learned to exemplify this. I remember the events in ISRO related to the successive failures of the launch of the first two augmented satellite launch vehicles, ASLV. Naturally, a sense of despondency overtook us initially. The ISRO engineers and scientists had an extraordinary way of responding to this, however, by bringing to bear the natural resilience in the mind has got to shift from one state to another. We did not allow this setback to override our resolve to succeed. By carrying out critical analysis and the associated follow-up steps to understand and address the problems, we paved the way for the success of the present generation of PSLVs and GSLVs. Our courage of conviction and the type of inspiration we derived from the leadership of ISRO made us work with redoubled vigor to succeed, which we did. I have often felt that life can teach you more from a failure than a success. In other words, the failures could be the stepping stones for the future successes. I would like to add to this connection the ancient wisdom from Confucius, a Chinese philosopher and reformer. Our greatest glory is not in ever falling, but in getting up every time we do. The second example that I would like to cite relates to our self-confidence into plan and realize. Science and engineering products that could match the best in the world. I recall with pride India's remote sensing satellite program and our early determination to reach world-class levels of performance. The task to build a satellite to contemporary standards comparable to the best in the world was really a big challenge considering the level of technology capability at our disposal. Nevertheless, our engineers came out with unique strategies, including innovative solutions. excuse me, for optics, pioneering the use of new state-of-art sensors and design and development of some of the most difficult technologies like gyroscopes, momentum wheels, and propulsion systems for the spacecraft. This was an extraordinary feat, completing we completed it in a period of 6 years. When the satellite IRS-1A was launched, its performance was comparable to the then contemporary American and French satellites. Not to be content with these achievements, the ISRO scientists went on to build IRS-1C and 1D in the next 5 years, wherein even more complex technologies and innovative solutions were brought to bear, making these satellites the world's best in the civilian domain. The stringent performance demands on the satellite launch, such as pointing and jitter stability to realize the full potential of the resolution capabilities of the camera from space, demand the highest level of perfection and precision on every aspect of engineering. The message that I would like to convey to my young friends is that given the right opportunity, goals and ambience, our youngsters are second to none in accomplishing any complex task. Further, when you do not follow the routes followed by others, you become a pioneer because of your originality of thinking and high level of innovations. When you are not following others, but still achieve world-class systems, you become a leader. Today, I can say with great pride that India has achieved a preeminent position in space research because of many of the foregoing reasons, particularly the availability of creative minds capable of displaying confidence and facing challenges. One unique aspect of India's successful space program that I would like to emphasize here is its ability to enforce the highest standards of quality and excellence as a part of each and every endeavor that goes into the building of a space system like a satellite or a rocket. This has to be a sustainable culture and cannot be a one-shot affair, since each space mission demands its own highest level of these practices. In the broader context of our country, the concept of excellence and perfection should be made a part of our national culture, elevating those islands like space to continental proportions. Nations which subscribe to this culture have the most decisive advantage to successfully compete with others in any endeavor. Very significant in the context of our present Prime Minister's Atmanirbhar program. My dear friends, the path to great achievements and success will put enormous demands on you and call upon you to bring to bear the highest degree of professionalism, inspired by being a part of a fast-changing knowledge ecosystem. This in turn will imply continuous updating of your knowledge and thus making the process of learning a lifelong experience. In the context of the need for graduates to be adaptable, lifelong learners, here is what Alvin Toffler, the American writer and the futurist, had to say, and I quote, "The illiterates of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn," unquote. You are among the fortunate few to have the opportunity for higher education in this very distinguished university. Education is not a one-step process, and it demands continuous striving to develop your personality in an integrated fashion. True education leads to the development of your physical, mental, and spiritual dimensions. As an educated citizen, contribute at least a small part of your time in the service of others. Also, do not forget that the true fruit of education is harmony. Never before in the history have been more in need of harmony than at the present time. Let us strive for harmony of thought and action, of science and religion, of individual and society, and anthropogenic action and environment. In other words, as inheritors of a society which has thrown up great values for life and a deep concern for human development, you should intensely aspire for deepening and broadening your knowledge. Learn to experience the power of collective teamwork and always be guided by higher values which you believe in. In all that lies before you, may God grant you wisdom, success, and true sense of fulfillment of your cherished ideals and goals. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite the Honorable Vice Chancellor.
Hello.
To introduce the Honorable Chancellor and request him to give his blessing to the graduates.
Before I request our Honorable Chancellor, Professor S.S. Dole, ji, let me have the proud privilege of introducing him. Dr. Sardara Singh Jol, internationally acclaimed agriculture economist, policy advisor, and Padma Bhushan awardee, has been the founder vice-chancellor of our Central University of Punjab for the term of 5 years. He had been the vice-chancellor of Punjabi University, Patiala, and also of the Punjab Agriculture University, Ludhiana. We are fortunate that a person of the stature of Professor Jol, who has immense experience in research and administration, is guiding us. Born on 2nd August 1928 in a farming family in district Lailapur, now in Pakistan, Dr. S.S. Jol had his early education in his village school. He had his B.Sc. Agri, M.Sc. Agri Economics, M.A. Economics, and Ph.D. Economics from Punjab University. After working for more than 8 years for rural and agriculture development in hill areas, he joined Punjab Agricultural University, Ludhiana, as an assistant professor and became the professor and head department of economics and sociology in 1965. During his long and illustrious career, Dr. Jol, former National Professor of Agriculture Economics, served as the Chairman, Commission for Agriculture Costs and Prices, Government of India, Member, Economic Advisory Council for 4 Prime Ministers of India, Director General, Director, Central Governing Board of Reserve Bank of India, and Vice Chairman, Punjab State Planning Board, in addition to numerous other prestigious positions. He adorned with unmatched clarity of vision and astute understanding of ground realities. In recognition of his professional contributions, concerns and efforts of social and cultural uplift of the society, many prestigious institutions have given him their highest awards and fellowship. He was conferred with degree of D.Litt Honorary Kaja by Punjab University Patiala and Punjab University Chandigarh, and D.Sc. Honoris Causa by Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar. Indian Council of Agricultural Research designated him as the Professor of Eminence in Economics. A life member of Punjabi Sahitya Academy, he is a Fellow of National Academy of Agriculture Science, New Delhi, and Punjab Academy of Sciences, Patiala. He has the honor of serving as President, Indian Society of Agricultural Economics, President of Agricultural Economics Research Association, President, Indian Society for Agriculture Marketing, and President, Punjabi Sahitya Academy. He has also served as consultant in FAO, World Bank, and Economic Commission for West Asia in many countries. In addition to his contribution as a scholar and policy advisor, Dr. Jol is a keen reader and literature whose interests go beyond economics and planning. He has been actively involved with research and planning, having 7 academic and research books and more than 200 articles published in various reputed national and international journals to his credit. His Punjabi non-fictional autobiographical book, Ranga Di Gagar, was widely acclaimed by both the ordinary readers and the scholars. It has been translated into many languages, including Hindi and Urdu. His other book, Mera Bharat Mahan, is also one of the best literary works. We are really very fortunate to have you, sir, with us on this eventful day of university. And now I most humbly request you, sir, to please bless our graduates and faculty members and staff of our university with your words of wisdom, sir.
Honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Tiwari, the chief guest online, Dr. Kasturi Ranjan, the deans of the faculties and heads of the departments, the Registrar of the university and the supporting staff, the teachers, dear students who have gained the degrees, honorable guests, particularly the First Lady of the university, Mrs. Tiwari, the press, who are present here, the parents who might be online, ladies and gentlemen, it is the sixth convocation of the university, and I am six times here on the dais. It's a special privilege to address all the convocations this university held. Unfortunately, today, this hall is such that I could not understand even a word of what was spoken here or online. And I am apprehensive that you will not understand what I say. This hall should have been checked. At least I heard only sounds. There's so much resounding here from this. I missed very particularly what Dr. Kasturi Ranjan has said. I requested the Vice Chancellor to get the address printed, get it, and distribute among the staff and the students. The progress I understood from the written pages. Now, I congratulate the graduates who have earned the degrees, master's degree and PhD degrees, and particularly double congratulations to the outstanding students who have got gold medals and recognition. I also congratulate the teachers and the non-teaching staff who have gained recognition today. I hope this trend will continue and they will improve upon what they have done so far. This university has earned a unique position. Number one, in the central universities, due to its performance, and also in the 100 academic institutions of the country with a rank of 87. There are only two universities, Guru Nanak Dev University and Punjab University, have come in this ranking. Otherwise, none from Punjab has gone into this.
very small university yet of only 11 years in that sense, and it has gained its position. It is because of your hard work of the faculty and the management of the Vice Chancellor too earlier that this university is rated number one. And I'm very happy the third Vice Chancellor which has come is also a very renowned scientist and an experienced Vice Chancellor. He will take the university to much higher heights. This is my hope. It is because of this that in the central admission test in counseling, the top ranking students' performance, they come to the university. And throughout India, out of 28 states is not a small thing. No university has got that spectrum of the students from different states. Similar is the case of faculty and supporting staff. It's a mini India where the cultures mix. For few years we have been holding these cultural functions. It was an enjoyable scene. India interacting. Unfortunately, this corona has spoiled this all. And to come in personal contact, it has become impossible these days. Hope 2021 will clear it off. Dear students, the universities, although have made such a good success, but my vision of the students getting out of this institution is having a character of nationalism, broad-minded, with honest conduct, integrity, and self-respect. The person who loses self-respect in the society is a zero person, rather negative person. Never fall in your own eyes. So if the institution succeeds in getting the personalities chiseled this way, it is a great contribution you will be making. But it is possible only if the teachers, you see, they absorb that, those characters. You are an open book. There is nothing like personal life. Even your personal life is also watched. Students don't learn from what you speak. Students learn what you do, what you perform, how you live, with what character, with what honesty, with what integrity. It's a great challenge on the teachers. You know, unfortunately, we have produced doctors, we have produced engineers, we have produced very clever politicians even. But we have not produced Indians. We are divided into states. We are Punjabis, we are Haryanvis, we are Himachalis, we are Madrasis, we are Bengalis, and all that. We are Hindu, Sikhs, Muslim, Isais, are jars, nonsense, banyas and all that. But where are the Indians? That we have not produced. And that's why we are going down the drain on our performance and character in this country. For this, the teachers are responsible. For this degradation, teachers are responsible. Teachers like a fountain. If the pure water flows out of this, the environment around is filled up this with amrit, nectar. But if the dirt starts oozing out of this, the whole system is spoiled. So if the teachers have spoiled it, then the teachers only can correct it. No one else. So it is the great responsibility on the teacher. I therefore exhort upon you to understand your responsibilities, to chisel the personalities of students in a manner that they become broad-minded nationalists with integrity, honesty, and that should be the religion of a person. Humanism is a religion above all, and that we need to develop. You know, I congratulate you on shifting to this campus. Even on a rented building we had the equipment unmatched by any university. We were rated, you see, A grade, and also this campus is proved as the top one. You are performing at top, and every one of your the faculty has got the projects from outside. This is rare. You will not find in any university, at least in the field like that. And that is because the university has provided a seed money with which you could start. In my assessment, the time is coming very, very hard on financial aspects. Every teacher should have a project. We should be of net return to the university. Means that should, along with the achievement of the research project, should have enough money to sustain even your salaries, and something should flow to the university. That is the way. Otherwise, we're very tight on finances, and the university will be developing infrastructure after taking loans, not direct money from the center. So it's a great responsibility on the administration, and also a great responsibility on the teachers, that you take this university on your own to the commanding heights. So with this, I also would like to apprise you of some handicaps this university is suffering because of the distance from the main city and the railway station. It's a connectivity difficulty. So what I suggest is that work with the ministry, the railway ministry also, at least there should 2 shatabdis coming and going morning and evening. When you get that, this you will be able to attract the faculty of a standard. The residential you will have. Another aspect the university should consider, plying the own buses every hour or morning, evening, convenient time, 4 times to the city and back. And also I suggest there should be a faculty guest house in the city. Trains come at midnight, and the faculty and the supporting staff and traveling from Delhi will be easy to get off the train and go to the guest house, and then in the morning one can come back. So it's a transit guest house of the faculty, and this will be the need. So long as there was a campus, fine. But now we're 20, 25 miles away from the main city, and this will be a problem. I hope with the finances available to you, this facility should be created for the staff. And here at the campus, it should be made a cycle-driven campus. There should be sufficient number of cycles. One should pick up from one building to the other at the top and so forth. No car or vehicle, four-wheeler, should be allowed in the campus. Not even motorcycles. But this is possible only if you have enough sufficient number of cycles available and to the faculty and the students. Only the guest cars can come in. I have seen your hostels also. For professors, there are four rooms, the bungalows, but there are one bedroom also there. In my opinion, no residential place should be less than two bedroom. Rather, the supporting staff at the lower level, normally they have a larger family, not a smaller family. So at least two rooms are possible. It is only people who are not married and they are single and want to have, that's okay. So please see that the whosoever is working at whatsoever level is a human being. He or she has a family and they have to live comfortably. This should be kept in mind. If I had known that there is a one room apartment, I would have said no. So now you reserve it for the singles. But in future, what you make a two bedrooms apartment for everybody. This is a wonderful campus, needs to be developed further. I have suggested to the Vice Chancellor that make a place as a fruit jungle. Otherwise, you green it as much as you like. You have a lot of land, at least 1 or 2 acres of land. Create a fruit jungle, I'm not say orchard. Create a fruit jungle where you walk in and don't take it to be a commercial one. Let the student walk in and eat it and enjoy it. That will be an attraction for the students and the faculty on this. There needs to be made a walk path around the campus. Very easy one. So that will keep you healthy by walking in this way. So create those unconventional facilities on this campus, which should be an attraction for the faculty and the students. So I'm glad that you have built enough hostels for the students, but as yet the rooms or the accommodation for the faculty is not full, because it is very difficult to live somewhere else and work here. Make it a city. You have only 2,000 students, but this university has a capacity of 19,000 students and 3,000 faculty and supporting staff. It will be a city of 22,000 people when it's fully done. And you need this self-sufficiency on all aspects of accommodation and facilities. I'm glad you have the waterworks, which purify the water from this canal water, and you are not suffering from in the water which is has got some elements which cause cancer here. So you are protected from that. So in the end, I'll congratulate you all of you, and particularly students and the teachers who made it possible for the students to achieve this. I do congratulate the supporting staff also, and also the parents who supported your studies. This is your mother institution's, dear students. Never let it down. You'll be known by this name of the institution. And I hope when you get settled in life, you will contribute back to this institution to dwell further. So take it as a family. Take it, your alma mater, as a home. When you return here, you should have pleasure to see this developing. And your contribution should also come to make this university a top-ranking university with all the possible facilities which should be available for the academics. So with these words, I congratulate you once again, the total students, faculty, administration, vice-chancellor, deans of the faculties, etc. So make it a university worth seeing. Because fortunately you have a space to play with. And many universities don't have that. So they're congested. But when I came in Salt Road, it looked like an aeroplane landing place. It was pleasure to see it. And you are lucky to live here. And therefore, own it, develop it, contribute to this. Thank you very much.
Now I invite Honorable Vice Chancellor to request worthy Chancellor to declare the convocation closed.
Honorable Chancellor, sir, please declare the convocation closed.
I declare.
Thank you, sir. Honorable Vice Chancellor, please felicitate our Chancellor. Honorable Vice Chancellor, please felicitate our chief guest online.
Chief
Now I call upon Dean Student Welfare to propose vote of thanks on behalf of the university.
Namaskar. Respected Dr. K. Kasturi Ranjanji, Padam Vibhushan Awardee, Professor Emeritus, Indian Institute of Advanced Studies, Chancellor, Central University of Rajasthan, and a well-known, globally recognized space scientist and former chairman of the Indian Space Research Organization, today's chief guest. Respected Dr. Professor Dinesh Kumar Singh Ji, Director, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, Bhatinda, and former Director, Rajendra Institute of Medical Sciences, Ranchi, and a well-known scientist and doctor in the field of hospital management, Professor Sardara Singh Johal, Padam Bhushan Awardee, Honorable Chancellor of our university, Professor Gurmeet Singh Ji, Vice Chancellor, Pondicherry University, Madam Karuna Tiwari Ji, First Lady of the campus, Professor Raghvinder P. Tiwari Ji, our dynamic Vice Chancellor, members of University Court, members Executive Council, member Academic Council, members Finance Committee, Shri K.P. Singh Mundra Ji, Controller of Examination and Registrar, Professor Ramakrishna Vasruka Ji, Dean in Charge Academics, Professor Anjana Munshi Ji, Dean Research, Deans of the respective schools, Professor S.K. Bawa Ji, Director IQAC, all the heads of the departments and in charges of various departments, Shri Chandan Mintal, Deputy Finance Officer, our Executive Engineer, Faculty Member, Staff Members, and Print and Electronic Media Personals, dear students, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of Central University of Punjab and on my own behalf on the occasion of 6th convocation of the Central University of Punjab, Bhatinda. First of all, I congratulate all the students who are awarded the degrees and those students who won the gold medals for their academic achievements for standing first in their respective groups. And I also congratulate the students, those are awarded or those have won the Sitaram Jindal Foundation gold medals. We are very much thankful to our esteemed chief guest, Dr. K. Kasturi Ranjan Ji, for taking out time from his busy schedule to be with us on this day. His learned views through his convocation address are invaluable for our students and young faculty members. His words are certainly going to motivate and guide us for years. Sir, you are an institution. Your every single word, your every single move is an advice for us. We are thankful to our worthy Chancellor, Professor S.S. Johal Ji, for presiding over this event. Sir, your presence to bless the fresh graduates of the university is a moment they will cherish throughout their lives. Your words of wisdom and your astute guidance is cornerstone of the progress and growth of our university. It gives me immense pleasure to record our gratitude to Honorable and Dynamic Vice Chancellor, Professor Raghvinder P. Tiwari Ji, who is guiding and encouraging us at every stage since his joining as Vice Chancellor. The university has progressed and is progressing enormously under the leadership of our Vice Chancellor. Sir, we are thankful to you. I am thankful to Sri K.P. Singh Mundra Ji, Controller of Examination and Registrar, and his entire team for the finest arrangements and successful completion of the convocation in virtual mode. I appreciate the efforts of various committees and their members who made this virtual convocation a successful event. I thank all the deans, all professors, faculty members, and staff for their valuable contribution to the success of this important academic function. I congratulate and wish a bright future for young and dynamic students who made the Central University of Punjab a vibrant and progressive university. I hope you all will miss your alma mater. I'm also thankful to the print and electronic media persons, those who have come all the way from Bhatinda and other places to witness and to witness this event. Thank you very much for your team spirit, and I'm confident with this vigor, university will achieve its objective in no time. I am very much thankful to everyone whosoever attended this function online. Last but not least, I thank one and all. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Now I request all to please stand for the national anthem.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड़ उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे Thank you.